I was super excited when this finally came in the mail. This, my friend, is the Bissell Steam Shot. It cleans only with steam and kills 99% of germs. You can use it for so many different things around your home, including your kitchen on grout, and I love using it on my kids' toys because it's not harmful.
Don't lie, you're so high.
Another day, another Amazon fave. This wireless handheld disinfecting gun is the coolest and most effective. Simply fill the 27-ounce container with disinfectant solution, and it can run for 2 hours on a single charge. It even includes 8 blue lights to help with sanitation. You can even control the amount of spray. It's perfect for book bags, the car, home, office, Lincoln bio.
Bathroom cleaning finds you just might need. If you've got mold in your shower, sinks, or tub, then watch what I'm about to show you. I found this product that instantly removes mold and mildew, and it's a real game changer. Just spray it on, and within 15 seconds, the mold comes right off, and no scrubbing needed.
On today's episode of Turning My Home Into a Smart Home, I'm going to review the world's first ever self-cleaning robot vacuum and mop, the Narwhal. You can use the same robot to mop and vacuum. All you have to do is switch out the attachments. To get started, the robot has to map your floor plan. It's equipped with cameras and LiDAR and does this faster than I've ever seen a robot do. When you're ready to mop, fill the clean water tank in the base station. This mopping robot is the best because it keeps going back to the base station several times during the mopping process to have its pads cleaned off, which means you don't have dirty, gross pads being dragged around your floor like other robots. Look how much dirt this thing scrubbed off my floors. I'm out of time and I didn't even get to the vacuum, so part 2 is posted on my profile right now. Go check it out. Amazon find number 58. So I have my go-to vacuum on Amazon number 8 that I absolutely love, but I've been seeing the Bissell Crosswave everywhere, so I was looking into getting one. And then I came across this. Reviews were overall really good, and I loved the fact that it had that self-cleaning mode. And the best part is it was about half the price. So I first used it as vacuum mode just to pick up any crumbs. And then on the handle, there's a little lever. So once you push that down, it actually disperses some of the cleaning product and changes it into mopping mode. And then I tried it in spot cleaning mode, which disperses a little bit more liquid and gives it a tougher clean. Now when I mop, I normally go with the grain of my flooring, but I wanted to go ahead in this video and do a little differently to see if I see any streaks. And look at all that dirt that it picked up. So then I just emptied out that water into the sink or the toilet, whatever you want. And then you can go ahead and put on self-cleaning mode. This is the best part.
Amazon Life Hack. This is a stain remover that works on clothing, carpet, fabric, and more. Literally, you just add a few sprays to the stain and it will disappear right before your eyes. I can't believe how well this works. Now time to throw it in the washer and it's good as new.
Show me the life hack that you randomly saw one day that is now an unconscious standard practice in your life. I'll go first.
This is a touchless motion sensor vacuum. The sensors activate so you can just sweep it by and it vacuums. No more bending down with an old dustpan to realize half of it slipped underneath. Great for dirt, pet hair, and other scraps. It also has a bagless canister that you can simply dump when full.
Three tips to keep your appliances clean. Every so often, you should remove and rinse the dishwasher filter. I also use this product for a deep clean once a month. Remove the cap, put it in the utensil rack, and let it run with the hottest temperature. This is great to remove any trapped particles, buildup, and residue. Next, you should clean your washing machine to remove buildup from detergent and oils left from your clothes. Pour half a cup of this solution in a tray and run it with heavy load and hot water setting. And lastly, you should clean your garbage disposal. I use this brush to scrub the inside, then drop in a packet of this cleaner, which cleans the pipes and is also satisfying to watch.
Here's an Amazon gadget you need if you have pets. I originally bought this lint roller to use on clothes, but I did not like the way it scraped my clothes. And then I had an idea. I decided to try it on my carpet. I literally Dysoned this carpet less than an hour before I did this. Look at the dog hair it got up just in that one spot. So I frantically did the entire rug. My chocolate lab leaves her DNA everywhere. Gross. So I linked this in my bio in case you need it.
The fact that you have to clean your windows sucks, but these e-cloths from Amazon make it a little less sucky. They have over 8,000 five-star reviews, and I can see why. Using water only, dampen your waffle knit cloth and get to cleaning. Then polish it with the polishing cloth, no chemicals involved. It's hard to see from this video how well it worked. Bonus tip, these little brushes are great for getting to those hard-to-reach areas under your window. The brush side loosens up the debris, and the flat side scrapes anything that's stuck on. I mean, look at that disgusting before and after. There's a reason everyone's obsessed with these products. Try them yourself at the link in my bio.
This is my KitchenAid range hood. If you have a stainless steel range hood like I do, then you probably have these baffle filters as well. They get coated with grease and oil, and it's gross and hard to clean. But this is how I clean them. I fill my sink with hot water, add two dishwasher tabs, which dissolve very quickly. Here's a closer look on how gross they are. I spray Dawn heavy duty degreaser, let it sit on it for 2 minutes, and then I add it to the hot water. And I leave it there for about half an hour. In the past, I've tried to use cleaning brushes, toothbrushes, and they don't work very well to clean these things. So now I just use a blue, non-abrasive scouring pad, along with this Pampered Chef Pots and Pans scraper. And if you don't have one of these scrapers, get one. They're amazing. I wrap the scouring pad around it and get to work. This works perfect for getting in between everything. When I'm done, I give it a good rinse, dry it off, and I use a soft microfiber cloth to buff it to a beautiful shine. It looks brand new again.
Wait, you know you're supposed to be cleaning your TVs, right? Well, today I will show you how to do it the right way. Now let's go.
Just look at that TV.
You need a Swiffer duster,
a spray bottle, some water, and some alcohol. 2 cups of water and 1/4 of a cup of alcohol.
First, make sure that your TV is off and it's cool. Now remove the excess dust with your Swiffer duster.
Now get a super soft microfiber towel. The fluffiest towels. Coming soon. Your mixture. Spray the cleaner in your rag, not on the TV.
I clean with one side, flip it, and dry with the other side. How pretty!
Okay, stop what you're doing and get this thing right here. This is a total game changer. This mop separates the dirty from the clean water. Dirty water stays at the bottom and the clean stays at the top. You just fill it up with water and of course the cleaner of your choice. Up in this compartment to let the water come in, put your mop in, rinse it up like this to remove the excess water and you get to mopping. Can you tell I am beyond excited for this? I am so excited for this. See, dirty water underneath. How pretty.